So starting about this time last year, a group of seven or eight Maine tribe health members got together, and we designed a strategic planning process that was intended to last all through this past year and culminate in the development of a strategic plan for the club that would be ready for us to talk to you about it this evening. And we were successful. We accomplished that. Once the process was put in place, we established a strategic planning committee. We solicited volunteers from among the club's membership first to join the strategic planning committee, and we had a good group that joined us. And then we also reached out to a bunch of key stakeholders in the community, including John Rogers, Will Thomas from Tri-Maine, Nan Cumming, who was throughout the process the executive director of Portland Trails, and a host of others. And with that group, we began developing a set of core values and statements of vision that we thought reflected what the Maine Track Club meant to be coming into the next 3 to 5 years. And once we developed all of that, we took those, that broad statement of core values and potential vision, and we vetted it. We took it to the summer picnic, and we had every participant at the summer picnic give input on which of these core values and which of these statements of vision really appealed to them. Then we brought it to the board, and we had the board give us their input. And then, with Chandra's help, we put out a survey to our entire email list, which includes Maine Track Club members and non-members who are also part of the running community. And we used that survey to test, again, those same statements, potential statements of core values and statements of vision, and also to solicit comments, written comments, not just yes, no, not just rankings, but what do you have to say about why you are a member of the Maine Track Club if you are? What do you have to say about why you're not if you're not? If you are a member, what do you like best about the club? What would you change about the club if you could? We had over 200 responses to that survey, which is really quite extraordinary. And we were able to collate all of those responses. And then finally, with all of that information, we held a one-day planning retreat, which was facilitated by Jan Kirst, who's the executive director of the Institute for Civic Leadership. Jan is terrific. She actually facilitated the strategic planning process for Outward Bound, and very able. That session was attended by members of the strategic planning committee, members of the board, and other members of the club who have some historical perspective. David Colby Young was there, as one example. Charlie Scribner was there. And that allowed us to really winnow down the broader lists using all of the data we had collected and begin to really think about what a strategic plan for this organization should look like. So with that done, we began with the articulated mission of the Maine Track Club. For those of you who don't know, this is the mission of the Maine Track Club as it appears in the bylaws, the current bylaws. So this, before we even started, this was and remains the mission of the Maine Track Club. To promote fitness and running, both recreational and competitive at all levels. Simple but timeless, actually. It really still describes exactly what the club is about. And what's interesting about that is that it does speak not just to running, but to fitness, and not just to competition, but also to recreational activity. So we took all of that and began putting together what we thought was the single vision for the track club based on the data. And this is what clearly came through. By 2015, the Maine Track Club will be providing a high-quality experience to its members at least equal to that offered by the most successful running clubs in comparable markets elsewhere in the United States. Now, a vision is supposed to be A, aspirational, and B, pretty general, because you fill in with goals and strategies underneath that. But this is really meant to be a guide for the board of directors and the club. Where do we want to be in 2015? We want to be at least as good for our members as the best clubs like us other places in the United States. Okay, so how do we put some meat on those bones? What does that mean? Well, that's what the goals are all about. First, and this is really, I'm going to just, a slight side note. This was one of the vision statements that we had originally articulated, and it transformed into a goal after a while because it became more and more sharpened. But this surprised me. In everywhere we vetted visions, whether it was at the picnic in August or with the board or in the survey of 1,000 or more people on our email list, this was consistently a top scoring interest. To have the Maine Track Club establish itself as an effective statewide advocate on running and fitness issues. So we heard you all, we heard everybody, that's now one of our goals. To establish the club as an effective statewide advocate on running and fitness issues. Now, we also have some ideas about how the club might go about doing that in the form of strategies. And I'm not going to go through all of the strategies, but on this one I think it's particularly interesting to see what kinds of strategies emerge for this. Promoting the Maine Track Club brand as an icon of Maine running and fitness, developing running and fitness education initiatives, and partnering with key stakeholders like Maine Running Company and the Pineland Training Center for training and events, adding and enhancing programming specifically for youth, seniors, and women. So those were all things that people responded to favorably and that really would, they're specific tasks that can support the goal of establishing the club as a statewide advocate for running and fitness. So, our second goal is that by 2015, the Maine Track Club will improve the efficiency, transparency, and accountability in its governance and finances. How are we going to do that? Well, we have it in mind that there are some revisions and updating to the bylaws that need to be done. Mark Grandonico has been kind enough to share with us some model bylaws that come from the RRCA. Our bylaws have effectively remained unchanged since the 1970s when the club was founded. And in today's world, those bylaws are not very efficient. They don't really give a lot of guidance to the club's board. It's a very different club than it was in the 1970s, both in numbers and in scope. And so we really do need to look at that. We want to develop a unified budget that includes all races and events. As it stands right now, races tend to have their own sort of insular budgets, and it makes it difficult for the board of directors to have a handle on everything that's going on at the same time. So the plan is to develop a budget that covers all of them. To establish guidelines and protocols for the disposition of event proceeds so that charitable gifts are more clearly and consciously mission-driven. As it stands right now, for the most part, race directors have pretty much complete autonomy to decide which charities benefit from their races, and there isn't any sort of overarching set of guidelines or protocols that tie those charitable gifts to the mission of the organization. So the feeling was that that would be a useful thing to have. And then finally, develop the board into a working volunteer board with fundraising responsibilities. As it stands right now, the board of directors of the Maine Track Club doesn't really have fundraising responsibilities. But if the board is going to, if the organization is going to take the next step into what it's going to be in 2015, there are going to be some financial consequences of that, and the board's going to need to be able to raise some money to support some of these new initiatives. Goal three, to establish an event as a recognized premier running event in the New England region. Our idea here is we have the Maine Marathon, which is a recognized premier event in the New England region. It would be a great thing for the club to have an event, a destination type event, and one of the sort of examples that's been discussed in the course of all the strategic planning is the Utica Boilermaker, which is a citywide event that takes a couple of days and draws 10,000, 12,000 runners every year. It's a huge, very, very popular, very successful event. And our thought is that by sponsoring and operating a festival or an event like that, the club could really raise its profile really in the region. And as a way of going about getting there, the strategies that have been developed are to focus more on Maine Track Club owned events and less on Maine Track Club supported events that are owned by others, to leverage our relationships with our community partners, reinvigorate the race committee, and fill the position of race committee chair, which has gone vacant for some time now, and work on the destination or signature festival event model, like the Utica Boilermaker 15K and 5K. And then finally, our last goal is to support actively and encourage members to identify themselves as Maine Track Club members when they participate in recreational and competitive running events. There are a lot of events around the area, and a lot of Maine Track Club members participate in the events, but for whatever reason, we tend generally not to identify ourselves when we register for the events as Maine Track Club members. And the thinking of the Strategic Planning Committee, which was supported by the data, was that another way for the organization to really raise its profile and increase the quality of what it delivers to its members is to encourage members to do that more. So our thinking about how to accomplish that is to update and improve the Maine Track Club website, encourage members to wear Maine Track Club gear at races, provide more race entry discounts for members, train and empower volunteers, and organize more non-race running activities like the weekly group runs. So that's really kind of the summary of the strategic plan as it has developed. And again, I want to emphasize that all of these goals and all of these strategies really came from the data drawn from our surveys and our polling of members and non-members alike, and key stakeholders in the community. So we're hoping very much that over the course of the next few months, we'll pass this much of the plan off to the board, and the board will then develop a series of action plans to put these strategies and goals into play and take us to our vision for 2015. So I think that's it. I'm glad to answer any questions if people have questions. Well, thanks. Look for your support.